Hello everybody, today we are going to see next type of construction, that is construction of a triangle when its base, sum of other two sides and one base angle are given. Okay, so if you will see a rough sketch for this, then suppose we are going to prepare a triangle. Now base is given, length of base is given, and what is given? Sum of other two sides, sum of other two sides. Specifically length of this or this side is not given, but sum of that two sides are given, and base angle are given. Base angle means either this angle will be given or this angle will be given. Okay, so we are going to see that type of such type of construction of a triangle with the help of one example. See here what is given. Construct a triangle ABC, construct a triangle ABC in which AB is equal to 5.8 centimeter. AB is 5.8 centimeter. Suppose we will see this is AB, that is 5.8 centimeter. BC plus CA, BC means this point we will say C, BC plus CA is 8.4 centimeter. Sum of the two sides BC and AC is 8.4 centimeter, and angle B is 60 degree. Angle B is given 60 degree. Okay, so these three things are given. Base is given, base angle is given, and sum of two sides are given, remaining two sides are given. And with the help of this, we are going to prepare now, we are going to construct now this required triangle. Okay, so see here, according to the given information, we will take here base. Okay, base of the triangle, base is given AB 5.8 centimeter. Okay, so 5.8 centimeter distance is very short for me, so I am taking little bit more distance. Okay, but when you will do the same construction in your notebook, that time you have to take exactly 5.8 centimeter. Okay, so 5.8 centimeter I am taking in the ratio, I will take little bit greater than that, that is 5.8 I am taking little more distance. So okay, so this point I am saying here A, and this point I will say B. Okay, AB is 5.8 centimeter exactly you need to take. So AB I have taken here. Okay, now what they have told us, angle B, angle B is 60 degree, angle B is 60 degree. So here we will prepare with the help of, directly with the help of protractor also we can do, or with the help of compass also we can do. I am doing with the help of compass. Okay, so now you know that how to prepare 60 degree, 120 degree angle. So here you need to take convenient radius. With the help of convenient radius, you can make here one semicircle which will intersect line segment AB in a certain point. Okay, so I have taken a semicircle. Now with the help of same radius, from this point, intersected point, you have to make one mark on, you have to take one arc on the semicircle. Okay, so when you will join this point with the with point B, then you will get 60 degree angle. Okay, so this point I am taking here, I am joining here now. So this point, okay, so this angle is 60 degree, this angle is 60 degree. Okay, what we have done, what we have done first, AB given length, okay, then angle B 60 degree. Okay, now what is given, see, BC plus CA is equal to 8.4 centimeter. Okay, last year whatever constructions we have done till last year, that time BC specifically it was given, BC suppose 4 centimeter, so directly we can take 4 centimeter and we can join. But here it is not given, here it is given BC plus CA is equal to 8.4 centimeter. Okay, so here what we are going to do, we will take 8.4 centimeter on this side only, 8.4 centimeter on this side only. Okay, so I am taking that 8.4 centimeter, that is approximately, I am taking more distance, okay, little more distance than that. So here, okay, so I need to increase this line, so it will be, okay, so I got a 8.4 centimeter, your 8.4 centimeter you will get here. Okay, so I am giving here D, that will be point D. Now I am going to join this D and A. Okay, so I will get a third side of triangle ABD. So I am taking here, I am joining point A and point D. With the help of dotted line also we can join it. But this is not our required triangle. Okay, we have to construct triangle ABC. Okay, point D we got here. Now one thing we need to do, that is we are going to do here, we are going to bisect side AD. We are going to bisect side AD. Okay, so bisection of side, everybody knows, so more than half distance you can take, more than half, this is half, more than half distance you can take, make arc both the sides from the D as a center, make one arc with the same radius. Okay, so here we got two points, so I am increasing little bit, then you can see it properly. Okay, so two points we have now, this one intersection point and these two arcs are intersected here. Okay, so now we can, if you will join this, then what we will get, we will get a line which is okay. So now here, if I will say this point is E, this point is E, then definitely AE and ED distance will be same. AE and ED, this distance line segment, the length of ED and EA will be same because this is the bisector. Okay. Now when you will extend this line, it will intersect, it will intersect side DB in point. In a point, okay, we will say that point C, that is our required point. Okay, C. Now what we have to do, we have to join this point to point A, means AC, we will get side AC. Okay, so I am doing that. Okay, so this is our required triangle ABC according to the given information. Okay, so now you will ask how AC and CB, AC plus CB is 8.4, you will get here, see this part DC and AC will be equal, because why equal, you can see here, suppose this is a line segment, if you will bisect it, then what you will do, you will take more than half distance and you will get such type of arcs. Okay, so definitely this and this is equal. Okay, so if you will take any point on this, if you will take any point on the this line segment or here downside, and you will join this, then definitely this and this will be equal. Okay, any you can take, this point is equidistant from this and this. Okay, suppose you will change the place, then too this is going to be same, this will be equal to this, this point is equidistant from this. So like that, point C is on the bisector. So definitely point C is equidistant from D and A, means AC is equals to DC. Okay, because afterwards we are going to justify it. So we must know that. In justification we need to write that. Okay, so first we will write steps of constructions in short, and then we will write justification for the same. Okay, so see carefully. Okay, steps of construction. Okay, so first what we have taken, first step, take a line segment AB which is length is given 5.8 cm. Okay, so construct line segment AB of 5.8 cm. Okay, first we have taken line segment AB 5.8 cm, then angle B, construct angle B, which is what is given 60 degree, okay. Construct base angle, that is given base angle B of 60 degree, okay. Then we have taken 60 degree. Then on B, means on that angle, okay, take a point D, take a point D, what we have done, take a point D, the distance of BD will be 8.4 centimeter, means the sum of that two sides we have taken on the same side, okay. So construct or take, construct BD, line segment BD of length 8.4 centimeter, means sum of both the sides we have taken on the same side, okay. Now third, fourth one, what we have taken, fourth one, join DA. Then fifth one, what we have done, construct bisector of side DA, okay. Construct perpendicular bisector of side AD, okay. That bisector will intersect, intersect two side, which side BD of triangle ABD, okay. This bisector will definitely intersect to BD at a center point. That point is our required point, okay. So now what we will write after this, step 8, okay. Intersection point, that is point C, join to point A, okay. So our required triangle ABC, okay. So here this is ninth triangle ABC is our required triangle, okay. So this way we have to do the construction when base angle is given, base is given, and sum of other two sides are given, okay. So that time we have to construct this way, okay. Now we will see justification, how to justify it, we have to prove it. Justification, see, I am saying here CD is equals to AC. CD, first statement I am doing here, CD is equals to AC. Why CD is equals to AC? CD and AC are equal. Why? Because point C is on the perpendicular bisector of side AD. Okay. Point C, here we can write reason, point C is on the perpendicular bisector of AD. Okay. And just now I told you perpendicular bisector. So any point you will take on the perpendicular bisector, that will be equidistance from D and A. Okay. So CA is equals to CD. This is first thing. Now what we have done here, BC plus CD is equal to BC plus CD. We have taken the required 8.4 centimeter. Okay. Now CD is equals to AC. So we can replace CD by AC. So I am doing that. BC, this BC as it is, plus CD I am taking here, AC is equal to 8.4 centimeter, which is given here. BC plus CA or AC, BC plus CA is equal to 8.4 centimeter. So here BC plus CA is equal to 8.4 centimeter. Okay. So this is our required triangle. Angle B we have taken 60 degree. Okay. Only we have to show what? We have to show that the sum of this side and this side is 8.4 centimeter or sum, whatever sum is given, that we have to show. Okay. So see carefully, once again I am telling here you, base we have to take AB, whatever given, AB whatever of given length, then given base angle that we have to construct, okay. Then you have to take the sum of two sides are given, that you take on one side, join that two points, construct a bisector, it will intersect two side BD or that side, okay, and join this intersection point to the this point, another base angle, okay. So you will get your required triangle. So this is our required triangle ABC, okay. Thank you.